Hello guys, this is Cesar Creates, and welcome back to my channel! So, as I promised you guys, in this episode of the Elm Hill City Zoo, we are adding the elephants to our zoo. In the last episode, we started to work on this new building for our zoo. This will be a house for the white rhinoceros and also the new elephant that we are adding today. So if you remember, I asked you guys what species of elephant I should add today. The comments were very mixed, that's why I decided to make a poll on my channel, on my community tab. And the African elephant won in that poll, that's why we are adding the African elephant today to the Elm Hill City Zoo. The African elephant got 62% of your votes, while the Indian elephants got 38%. So yeah, as you guys decided, today we are adding the African elephant. I am super excited because I wanted to have the elephants from the very beginning in this zoo. I think that they are such an iconic staple animal to be in the typical city zoo. So yeah, today we are adding them, and I hope that you'll like this new enclosure for our zoo. I hope that people who voted for the Indian elephant are not disappointed. I think that maybe, I don't know, we'll add the Indian elephant as well to the zoo at some point. I'll think about it for sure. But yeah, the African elephant won, and that's why we are adding it today to our zoo. So in today's episode, we'll be using some things that I already created for the white rhinos for us last time. So in case you haven't seen that video where we started this building and where we built the habitat for the rhinos, the link will be down in the description to this video and on the screen right now, so you can go and check it out. I would like to take some time to thank you guys for the amazing feedback under the last video, for all the comments on the Facebook where I post the photos of this habitat, and for all the comments on my YouTube and Instagram about how you loved this habitat. This really means a lot to me, and I am super grateful for all of those comments, so thank you, I am super happy that you like this habitat so much. Okay, so as you could see, we already created a mold for this habitat. I used the same one that we used for the rhinos. I just made it a little wider because, you know, the elephants have long trunks. So to make things safe for the guests, I decided I would make it a bit wider. So in case the elephants would, want to reach the guests or reach the fence or the plants that are on the mold, with their trunks, they will not able to do so because it's a bit wider. We already added the fence for the guests and the fence around the building for them. Also, we created those things last time in the rhino episode. So if you want to see how I created them, definitely go and check out this video. If you haven't watched my latest episode from the Desert Adventure Park, the Bongo Habitat, let me just quickly repeat that. You may notice that something is different about this video, and the thing that is different is actually the quality of my speech. Yeah, I invested in a new microphone. It's the first like major investment into my channel, and I hope you guys will be able to hear the difference. I am super glad that I bought it because I see a huge difference, and this is something that I wanted to buy for like several months now, and I finally did it. So yeah, I want to make sure that my videos are the best that I can make them, so buying a new microphone was on my list to do so, to improve the channel, and now I did it, so I am super happy. If someone wonders, my new microphone is the Elgato Wave 3. It had very good reviews online, many streamers and YouTubers use it, so I decided to buy it, and I am very glad that I did. Okay, but let's go back to today's video. As you guys can see, I already started to work on the swimming area for our elephants. The elephants love the water. They also require a water area in the game to be happy, so I definitely wanted to give them some swimming space, but this time I wanted to make it a bit cooler. I came up with an idea of glass wall so that the guests will be able to see the elephants while they are swimming. Elephants actually can dive, so they don't dive in game, but if they could, they definitely would dive in here, so the guests would be able to see it through the glass wall, and I think that it is a very cool idea. Creating it was a bit of a struggle. I had several attempts, but finally I did something that is more or less what I planned for the very beginning. I wish it was a bit bigger, because when I added 4 elephants in here, they had not enough of water area, but I mean, comparing to their size, I think it's totally okay. Like, elephants have smaller swimming areas in zoos, or they don't have any. So I think that it looks cool. It doesn't look too small for them, but for the game requirements, it is a bit too small. So yeah, I used a lot of concrete and plaster pieces to create this swimming pool or swimming area for them, and they are using it a lot, so I am very, very happy about it. So since my last video, a lot of things happened in the Planet Zoo community. We had some news about the update and about the new DLC, which I am super, super excited about. It is my first video since the new DLC has been announced, so let me give you guys my thoughts on it. So the new DLC is obviously the North America Animal Pack. And let me just say that there are so many animals that the community of players actually requested. So I am super happy that Frontier does listen to us. There are a lot of, you know, polls, a lot of questions on the forums about the animals that we want to see in the game. And those animals were mentioned by you and by me many times. So yeah, I am super, super happy with the lineup of animals that is chosen. That was chosen for this pack. I think that it is an excellent pack. Excellent animals will be added. I already have so many ideas for the new habitats. Of course, it is an animal pack, so we'll get 8 animals, 7 habitat animals, and 1 exhibit animal, just as with the Southeast Asia animal pack. I'm actually quite happy about it. We get 8 new animals. It is quite a lot. To be honest, I didn't even include all of the 8 animals from the Southeast Asia animal pack to our Elm Hill City Zoo. I never like added clawed leopards, for example, because I simply like didn't have time. And they didn't fit to any parts of my zoo, so I didn't want to make it just to force it to add one. So I am... But with this pack, I can see all of those animals in our zoo, so I will definitely add them all. I don't know if it'll be like straight away when the pack will be released, but I think that they just suit like perfectly to the Elm Hill City Zoo, and I am super happy about it. I'm of course a bit sad that we don't get any new construction pieces, because as you guys know, I love building in this game, but we got so many nice pieces in the Africa pack that somehow I am still happy, because I still, you know, they are still feel new to me, so I use them all the time and I didn't get bored of them. So yeah, it's a pity that we don't get any new construction items, but 8 animals, it is just amazing. So the animals that we'll be getting are the American beaver, and this is animal that I am actually, I think, the most excited about, because I love the beavers. I think that they are very cool animals, and yeah, building for habitats for them will be very, very cool. We also got the moose, the California sea lion, the cougar, the American alligator, the prairie dog, and Arctic fox, and also the American bullfrog as an exhibit animal. So yeah, all of those animals are so iconic and so cool. I love the moose. I wanted it from the very beginning of this game. Then there's a sea lion that many players wanted to have. You know, it is also a staple like City Zoo animal, so I think that we'll build something like very classical for them in this zoo. We have the cougar, which is a really, really cool big cat. Then we have the prairie dog, which is said to be the smallest animal actually in Planet Zoo. So yeah, also very exciting because you know how I love to build for those smaller animals. Also, the alligator was also very requested by the players. Right now, we'll have an alligator, the crocodile, the gharial, and the caiman. So we'll have all of the crocodilians in the game. So it is super cool. And yeah, the Arctic fox, they are super cute. And it is actually the first fox in the game. So yeah, this is so, so amazing. I cannot wait for it to be released. The release date is on the 4th of October. So yeah, my alarm clock is set. I will start, you know, recording those videos as soon as I'll grab it, as I will download it from Steam on this Monday. And yeah, I hope that we'll create something very cool for those animals. Frontier actually also released like a roadmap how they will like reveal the animals. So yesterday the beaver was released, tonight we'll have the sea lion, and so on. So this is also really cool because I love to see what is in like ahead of us, what they will like show us. So yeah, this is huge difference from the things that they did in the past, because they didn't like release any of those roadmaps, any of the plans that they have. So now we have a roadmap like this, and I think that it is super, super amazing. So yeah, the North America Animal Pack, the hype is real. I am super excited. I cannot wait. I still will have some of the, you know, new episodes before it drops, so stay tuned for the channel because many new episodes are coming. There'll also be a little surprise for you guys. I hope that you like it. I'm not saying anything more, but yeah, stay tuned and watch my channel because there'll be something very, very new on it. Also, the timing is actually perfect for the Elm Hill City Zoo, because in this episode I will finish the outside part of the elephant enclosure, and on the next Saturday probably I will have the next episode where I will be finishing the building. I will do all the interiors with the night stalls of the for the animals, and for with the area where they will spend the winter, where the guests will be able to see them during the winter. So yeah, this is the plan for the next episode, so definitely stay tuned for that if you want to see like a realistic build of the shelter for the elephants and the white rhinos. Okay, so let's go back to today's video. As you guys can see, I already am done with the water area. I created like those little, I don't know, stairs or things that like will help the animals to go out and into the water without the surface being too slippery. I thought it was will be a cool addition, something for the sake of realism. So while looking for inspiration for this habitat, I noticed that many of, you know, zoo city zoo habitats for the elephants are very, very plain and boring, and you know, there are just some stones, rocks, and some logs for them. There are some you know, zoos that have something cooler prepared for them, but in general those habitats are very, like, I would say maybe not boring but very empty. You know, those animals need a lot of space but also they destroy a lot of things. Like if you give them a tree, like plant a tree in the habitat, they'll actually, you know, tear it down, eat it, destroy it, because when they are bored and when they have something new in their enclosure, they're very curious. They are also very smart animals, so they need to be enriched, and so giving them too much in the habitat will end very badly. That's why those habitats are very like plain. I still wanted to give them some trees. I didn't want to give them a lot of plants because I knew that they didn't have a chance of survival. I will add some grass and some like dry bushes or something that they won't probably eat. This habitat was actually like inspired by two separate habitats, but those two separate habitats are in Germany. The first one is the Berlin Zoo, which I visited many times. And the second one, I hope I will pronounce it in the right way, but it is called the Karlsruhe Zoo, also in Germany. So they have a really cool animal, like elephant enclosure. It is actually an Indian elephant enclosure. So yeah, I was inspired by this one as well. So yeah, they obviously have a lot of stones and a lot of logs and a lot of dead trees in them. They don't have many like natural trees. Maybe the Berlin Zoo is a bit of exception, but they have the trees covered with those large tree protections. So yeah, this is something that I also wanted to give them. As you could see, we like extended the protections that we created last time for the rhinos, because I still wanted those habitats to be somehow similar to each other. That's why I decided to use a very similar design for the tree protections, and I also added some rock formations as those habitats that I was inspired by. They also have those the elephants actually like to scratch like against the rocks and so on, so that's why I wanted to give them that as well. Also, as you can see, I created my custom dead trees, because the broken or dead trees that we have in game, they're very like, it is just a tree trunk and nothing else. They don't have any branches and nothing like this. And those dead trees that I saw in those enclosures, they actually have branches. They are like large trees, but without any leaves, that are obviously dead. And maybe they are like put into the ground with concrete that is holding them under the ground, so it is like secure from the large elephants. I hope that you know what I mean. I'm not sure how to call it in English, but you put you make a hole in the ground, you put the like large tree trunk or something, and then you pour in the concrete, so it is more secured into the soil, into the grounds. And this is something that I imagined for this habitat. So yeah, I created those dead trees from the Australia log, and also the branches from the aquatic pack, the stone branches. I found this perfect color that was matching the log, and yeah, I wanted to give them some of those trees so that they can, play with them, with their trunks, they could scratch against them. There'll be some like custom enrichment with the tire that, they can play with it a bit. Also, the keepers sometimes put some food for them to find on those branches, higher branches, so you'll be able to see me putting some small baskets on the later stage, and putting some leaves inside of those baskets so that the elephants could actually go and look for some food. As you can see, I also created some like custom enrichment item I saw in the Karlsruhe Zoo. It is like a wooden structure with some suspended small logs that the animals can play with. It is very important for the elephants that they are enriched, that they have something to do, that they stay in group, because otherwise they easily get depressed in zoos, so you know the keepers need to do everything they can to make them, you know, interested, make them happy, make them enriched. So adding things like that made sense to me, and I wanted to create some more of the enrichment items than we have in the game. Actually, of course, the animals won't be able to use it in the game, but I still wanted to add them. Okay, so while I am adding all of the stones, rocks, branches, and all of the logs and plants to this habitat, let me give you guys some quick facts about the African elephant. So the African elephant is the world's largest land animal. The male African elephant can reach 3 meters tall and weigh between 4 to 7.5 tons. Elephant tusks never stop growing, so the enormous tusk can be a sign of an old elephant. Both male and female African elephants grow tusks, but only male Asian elephants grow them. So yeah, the African elephants, both male and female, have large tusks, while, you know, in Asian elephants, only the male has them. African elephants spend between 12 to 18 hours a day eating grass, plants, and fruit. They use their long trunks to smell their food and lift it up to their mouth. African elephants have created their own sunscreen. They first bathe in the water, and they throw mud and sand up over themselves to protect their skin from hot burning sun in Africa. The trunk is actually an elongation of the upper lip and nose. It is manipulated by 40,000 to 60,000 muscles. Because of its muscular structure, the trunk is so strong that the elephants can use it for lifting about 3% of their own body weight. They use it for smelling, touching, feeding, drinking, dusting, sound protection, defending themselves, and attacking. Mean weight of the tusks of the African elephant at the age of 60 years is 109 kilograms in bulls and 17 kilograms in cows. The longest known tusks of African bush elephant measured 3.51 meters and weighed 117 kilograms. They are very smart animals and have excellent memory. Since 2021, the African bush elephant has been listed as endangered. It is threatened foremost by habitat destruction, but also for poaching for meat and ivory. Their populations are dropping because simply they don't have any more place to live because of the agriculture and also because of hunting for the ivory. So please don't support the ivory markets whenever you see something made from, you know, basically elephant bones. Don't buy it because it's causes those beautiful, large, intelligent animals to die out, and this is super, super sad and alarming. And those are the moments that I am actually not proud to be a human being. So as I told you guys, the elephants love the mud baths. They use it to protect their skin against the harsh sun. That's why we are adding the mud bath for them in this habitat. I wanted to add it in a similar way that we did for the white rhino, sorry, because I got some comments that you like how I use that thing in there, so I wanted to repeat it a bit because I also think that it looks really, really cool. Let me just tell you one very, very annoying thing about the African elephants in this game. Their traversable area is just insane. So I finished building this habitat. I thought it looked really, really cool. I added a lot of, you know, details like those logs, those aquatic small rocks and so on. And I let in our elephants, and suddenly they couldn't like move 5 centimeters from the gates of the habitat because the habitat was simply not traversable for them. They need so much space to move in their habitats, like they need so much space between all the objects. They cannot walk through the small, you know, those small stones, aquatic stones. So it was a huge problem. I had to like rebuild some parts of this habitat just because they couldn't like go there, they couldn't move in there. So yeah, that was a bit a pain in the butt, let me just say, but yeah, I had to do it to be to make this whole habitat functional. I wish it looked a bit different in the end, but yeah, I have to live it with that. I want the animals to be able to use the entire habitat, and this is what I had, simply what I had to do. One thing that is still like unsolved is that the gate or the entrance to the building that we've built for the white rhinos is also too small for the elephants. So I will have to rebuild it in the next episode. It is just the opening is too small. They cannot go through it. It is a bit crazy. I wish it was somehow like improved or updated, because you know, it is so hard to build like a detailed habitat for those animals because they simply cannot move in there. So yeah, I wish that it was actually a bit looking a bit you know, different. It is a bit plain in the end, but this is something that we have to live with because I wasn't able to do anything more about it. In a second, I will start to work on a small holding pen for those animals. Maybe I will make it bigger in the future. I will see. It all depends on how big the building will be because I still don't know it. So the holding pen is created with some custom fence that I saw in the Karlsruhe zoo. It is a very thick and solid metal fence and I really like the design of it, so I wanted to use it. So we'll have a small holding pen that will actually be like an airlock, so you can, the elephants can, if the gate is open, they can go through it and go to another part of the habitat, because you know, that habitat that I've built for them, I think that it is totally okay for elephants when they will have an additional like space inside of the building. Habitats in zoos are often a lot smaller for them, but I still wanted to give them more space just to be nice to them. So I created this like another part of the habitat where they can go and rest a bit from the guests. It will be more covered with the foliage and so on, so if they want to be like more private, when they want to spend some time without being seen so much by the guests, they can go in there. And And as you will be able to see in a minute, for that part I use the fence that we created in the rhino episode. I use it in like a bit round shape, and in the middle of that I wanted to actually use this thing somewhere in the main part of the habitat, but I obviously didn't have any space because of their crazy traversable area. So I used it here and I went for a bigger version of it. It is something that I actually saw in the Berlin Zoo and I wanted to include in here. Like I saw at the beginning, it is hard to have a lot of plants and trees in the elephant enclosure because they will simply eat them, tear them apart and, you know, destroy them completely. So in Berlin Zoo, they still have some plants and some, you know, trees so that the habitat looks a bit more green. But those are actually behind like a mesh with very like strong construction so that you know, the animals cannot reach to them. So I created like this circular shape of mesh and metal pieces in which we'll have a very lush green like burst of trees, bushes and so on. So it will provide a very very nice look for the habitats. It'll give them it more of the like green lush feeling, but also will give some shadow to the animal. It will give some privacy to them. They can hide behind those trees and those bushes, and I think that it looks really cool. Again, it was inspired by the thing that I saw in Berlin Zoo, and I really like how it is looking at the end. Okay, guys, this is all that I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed our new video with African elephants, which you have actually chosen yourself for the Elm Hill City Zoo. So yeah, this is actually a really nice habitat. I really like it, and I cannot wait for this area of the zoo to be finished, so it will look even more better with, you know, all the surroundings done and this building being finished. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. It really will mean a lot to me. It will help our little channel to grow. So yeah, click that subscribe button if you want to see my future videos, if you want to see me build more in the future. I would be very, very grateful. Also, comment down below if you like this video or if you have any suggestions for my future videos. I try to reply to all the comments, so for sure your comment won't be unnoticed. Hit the like button if you like this video, and also ring the bell if you want to be notified every time I upload a new video. Guys, we'll have a new DLC soon. I am again super excited. So as I told you, expect many new videos with the new animals from the North America pack. Thank you guys for watching, have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye guys! Thank you.